In this video lecture, I will show you the process of combining different forms in Visual Basic. So make sure meron tayo ngayong apat na folders, yung tatlong problems na ginawa ninyo ng application, the average, factor finder, and factorial, at meron kayong isang combination folder or combination app that will mix or combine or link together these three applications na ginawa ninyo. Okay, so malalaman ninyo kung tama ang inyong ginawa kasi when you open each folder, so for example, in the average, meron kayong tatlong files na makikita. So we have the computer.jpg or the background picture na ginamit ko dito. So sa inyo, you might be using other pictures or images, so that's okay as long as nandito siya sa pagbukas mismo ng folder ng inyong application. Then we have the solution file and meron tayong subfolder at may ganitong mga files. So bin, my project, obj, averagedesigner.vb, average.resources, average.vb, average.vbproject, and average.vbproject.user. So dapat sa apat or sa tatlo pang applications, ganito rin yung laman. Okay, so let's look at combination. So we also have three files. Then we have the subfolder which contains these files. Then, in our factor finder, meron din tayong tatlong files. At sa subfolder na factor finder, we have these contents. Okay. And on our factorial application, we have the three files as well and subfolder which contains the following. Okay, so make sure na meron kayong apat na folder so far. Sinave ko lang ito sa desktop. And let's check each form one by one. So let me start with the average. So this is my form for the average. Okay, so make sure na yung bawat application ay gumagana. Walang syntax error, walang logic error para pag pinaglink na natin sila, tuloy-tuloy na lang yung pag-run ito. So let me try this average application. Okay, so this is my average app. We have the label, the button, numbers entered. So, bawat kuha natin ng number from the user ay madi-display dito. Then, at the end, the average will be shown. Of course, clear data button must also work. Buburahin lang naman yung laman itong list box at ng text box na ito. So, let us try get numbers. So, for example, I will input 5 numbers only. So, when I press OK, so the computer or the program will ask me to input the 5 numbers. So, let's have 1. Then, 2. Then, I'll put hello. So, dapat ang program nyo dito ay may pansala, may pang-filter kapag hindi integer yung pinasok ng user. So, when I press OK, we have here an invalid message na nagsasabing please input a numeric input. So, we have to try again and enter a valid number. So, we have 3, 4, and 5. So, there are 5 numbers entered and these numbers are 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So, ang total niyan is 15 divided by 5. So, we have 3 as the average. At when we clear the data, nabubura yung ating mga contents for the list box and for the text box. So, gumagana yung average problem. Okay, next na kailangan ninyo siguro doin ay gumagamit kayo ng tamang naming conventions. So, malalaman nyo naman yan pagka-click nyo ng form nitong average. For example, you have here in the properties panel, FRM average. Ito ay LBL title, BTN get, another label, and we have the list box, pinangalanan ko siyang LST numbers entered, and we have another list box for the result, and another button for the clear data. Okay, another thing is, kailangan mahanap nitong Solution Explorer. Kadalasan, paano nyo ito makikita? When you click the form, okay, makikita nyo dito yung properties. Tapos dito, meron tayong Solution Explorer. Kung hindi nyo ito nakikita ngayon, malamang ay nasa toolbox kayo. Okay, where you can drag the different controls papunta sa form. So kapag nasa toolbox kayo ngayon, click on the Solution Explorer para makita nyo itong mga files na ito. And what you need to do is to click on average.vb at makikita nyo dito sa right. Okay, kung form 1 ang nakalagay sa inyo, pakibago yan at gawin yung average. Okay, para maging average.vb, para mamaya, pagtingin nyo sa folder ng average, napalitan na rin, no, yung mga pangalan at hindi na puro form 1 katulad ng mga nangyari nung nakaraan. Okay, so make sure your name here is average.vb. Okay, so we're done with the average. So average app is okay. Para hindi na natin balik-balikan. Okay, let's proceed to the factor finder. So let me skip yung combination muna. So in my factor finder application, okay, ito yon. So let me run the factor finder application. Okay, so this is my factor finder application and I'll put for example 8. No, alam natin na yung factors ng 8 is 8 and 1, then we have 2 and 4. Pero sa aking form, may dinagdag akong radio button and I don't want to include the given number which is 8 and 1 as factors. Hindi ko pa to tinuro yung radio button, so if you don't have this control, okay lang. No, so let me try 8. So I am expecting 1, 2, 4, and 8 as factors pag hindi ko to kinlik. So find factors, so correct, meron akong 1, 2, 4, and 8. So let me clear the data, pakita ko lang sa inyo kung sakaling kinlik ko yung radio button na ito, don't include the given number and 1 as factors, dapat ang makikita lang natin dito sa list box ay, yes, 2 and 4. Okay, so correct. So clear data, so it works. So wala tayong problema dito sa factor finder. Again, hindi kayo required na maglagay ng radio button ngayon. But if you want to make your program more accurate, okay, try to research for the functions of the radio button. Okay, so let me close this application. Tinry lang natin yan para masiguro na itong factor finder app is okay. So let's proceed to the third application. We have the factorial. So here's my form for the factorial. Okay, so make sure na nagra-run din yung factorial. Okay, so this is my factorial app. And let's have an example. So if I enter hello, for example, so dapat may validation. No? Hindi nawawala yung validation natin. It's a rule in programming that in every input, there must always be a corresponding validation or checking. So when I enter the string or a text, hello, and click on the button find factorial, meron tayong invalid message na nagsasabing, please input a numeric value. Okay? When I press 0, alam natin that by rule, sa mathematics, 0 factorial is equal to 1. So I have here 1 as the result. Okay? Then we have, for example, 4. 4 factorial is basically 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, which is equal to 24. Okay? So find factorial, so we have 24. But notice, meron ako ditong list box for computation, na wala naman ito, hindi ko kayo ni-require maglagay nito. So this is just to show you that I can actually list down the process or the computation on how I got the result of 24. Okay, so clear data is working as well. So let me close this factorial app. At nakalimutan ko kanina, no, sa factor finder, dapat, katulad ng ginawa natin sa average, you go to the solution explorer and make sure when you click factorial.vb or baka form1.vb dyan sa inyo ngayon, when you click that, you can edit it here at gawin yung factorial. Okay, kanina, dun sa average or sa factor finder, hindi natin nagawa. So, ganun din yung dapat gawin ninyo. Go to the solution explorer, click on the form1.vb, kung yan yung pangalan ng inyong form ngayon, and here, you can change on the properties panel the name or the file name of your application. Okay, so dapat gawin nyo yun sa average, factor finder, at saka sa factorial. Okay, so far, our three applications are working. So the factorial app is okay. And so we'll go to our combination form. So ito yung itsura ng aking combination form. I have a label. I have three buttons, factor finder, factorial, at average. So yung goal natin, when we click factor finder button, it will link to our factor finder form and will allow us to have our process for looking for the factors of a number. So let's go back to the combination application. So ngayon wala pa itong code. So lalagyan natin ito ng codes. Okay, pero bago niyan, dahil iko-combine natin yung iba't ibang forms, ito yung process niyan. So same din sa ginawa natin sa average, factor finder, tsaka sa factorial, go to the solution explorer of our combination form. Okay, and in the solution explorer, click on the form 1.vb kung hindi nyo pa sakali siya na-rename. And make sure na na-rename nyo siya dito at gawin nyo siyang combi or whatsoever name na gusto ninyo. So make sure tandaan nyo lang yung name because we will access each form mamaya.